Sir, sound Asuji?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sudhir, sir. Sudhir, sir. Sudhir, sir.
Oh, sir, sir.
Sudhir, sir.
Okay. Okay. So, good afternoon, all dear learners. Good afternoon, Sudhir, sir. Bhavesh, sir. So, I welcome the second session of information security, that is CSP 12. So today, sir will discuss the second unit, that is security threats and vulnerability. So I request Sudhir sir to take over the session and start.
Okay, sir. Today my topic, my first discussion about threats. Threats can, what is the meaning of threats? Threats means this is a type of vulnerability to impact the performance of a system. Normally we are using 10 type of threats. First one is distributed denial of service attack, DOS attack. Second one is
All the learners are requested to mute their mic. All the learners are requested to mute their mic.
Sir, video ta share karchi dekhi parchun to? Sir?
Okay, sir.
हाँ सर वीडियो टा शेयर कर चुके देख कर चुन दो
ना सर आसिल लाने
सुने
ना
वीडियो टा शेयर ही करने
अपन को माइक टा भी म्यूट है जाई ची
माइक टा म्यूट है चुके
ना क्यों ना की उड़े सो सो ब्रोट पंडे के कुछ वो जो हो
सुब्रत परिडा इज प्रेजेंटिंग सुब्रत परिडा
ओके सुब्रत परिडा प्लीज स्टॉप प्रेजेंटिंग सुब्रत परिडा प्लीज स्टॉप प्रेजेंटिंग सर प्लीज
सर सर असला की फाइल टा प्रेजेंटिंग सर आसुनी टिकट चेक करले
नहीं सर आसुनी तो
से सुब्रत परडा कटला पर तो कहीं आसिया का पता मनु
तो मेरी तो कल उसी मैं तो मैं फेरे रिजन करूंगा
रिजन कौन करेगा पुरे
प्रेजेंट नाउ करूं तू
प्रेजेंट नाउ
से देखो नहीं आ इधर नहीं
सर
असल है कि
नो 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 सर सर आपने जेमितिया फाइल शेयर करों तो सेमितिया शेयर कर दियों तो अब
सर अभी आसना कि
नहीं तो सर आसुनी
नहीं मैंने अभी प्रेजेंट सुन बोला
ସାର୍ ଏବେ ଆସିଲା ଆସୁନି ପୁରା କହୁଛନ୍ତି ସାର୍ ଆସୁନି ଏବେ ଆସୁନି ନା
ନାଇଁ 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 ଆସୁନି ପିପିଟିଟା ନା ଭିଡ଼ିଓଟା କ'ଣ
ପିପିଟିଟା ସାର୍ ପିପିଟିଟା
ହଁ ପିପିଟିଟା ସେ ତ ସେୟାର କଲେ ଡାଇରେକ୍ଟ ଆସିବା କଥା
ସାର୍ ଆସିଲା କି
ନା ସାର୍ ପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟ ହଉନି
ସାର୍ ଯଦି ଯଦି ପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟ ନ ହଉଛି ତାହେଲେ ଇଏ ମାନେ ଏମିତି କ୍ଲାସ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟ କରିଥାନ୍ତୁ ଚାଲିଥାଉ ହେଲା
ଆସାଇନମେଣ୍ଟରେ ପକେଇଦେବୁ
ସାର୍ ୱି କ୍ୟାନ୍ କଣ୍ଟିନ୍ୟୁ ୱିଥଆଉଟ୍ ଦ ପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେସନ୍ ଆଇ ୱିଲ୍ ସେଣ୍ଡ ଦ ପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେସନ୍ ଟୁ ଏଭ୍ରି ୱାନ୍ ଓକେ ସାର୍ ଜଷ୍ଟ ୟୁ
ଦେନ୍ ୱି ଡିସ୍କସ୍ ଦ ଟାଇପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଥ୍ରେଡ୍ସ
କ୍ୟାମେରାକୁ ସାର୍ ଖାଲି ଅନ୍ କରିଦିଅନ୍ତୁ ଇଣ୍ଟରାକ୍ଟିଭ୍ ହେବ ଟିକେ ଆଉ ହେଲା
ସାର୍ ନର୍ମାଲି 10 ଟାଇପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଥ୍ରେଡ୍ସ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ସିନ୍ suppose Daniel distributed Daniel of service attack and then old browser or vulnerability plugins attack browser vulnerability are frequently you have to check the vulnerability of the browsers suppose like Oracle Java Adobe Flash and readers these are currently requires updates in every moment then good sites hosting and bad content attacks mobile apps and on secure web attacks this type of bring your own device movement has to lead to a search in consumer owned device inside the corporate firewalls calling to clean and bad inputs it means SQL injections are normally happening in case of web application security projects then digital certificates the hazards of digital certificates this is of one type of threats also then scripting problems is cross site scripting problems attackers are normally giving some blank sites which cross site scripting vulnerability can run scripts to login box on the banker's page and steal users credentials this is one type of attack also in insecure internet of things suppose you are using routers printers video conferencing systems door locks and other devices in that case
excuse me sir ଆପଣଙ୍କ ସାର୍ କ୍ୟାମେରାଟା ଅନ୍ କରିଦିଅନ୍ତୁ
ଆସିଲା କି ସାର୍ ନା ବାବୁ ଟିକେ ଦେଖିଲୁ କ'ଣ କ୍ୟାମେରା ଆସୁନି ଆସୁନି
ଆରେ ଇଏ ତମେ ନୁହଁ ତମ କ୍ୟାମେରା ଅନ୍ ଅଛି
ଆସିଲା କି ହ୍ୟାଲୋ ଭବେ ସାର୍ ଆସିଲା କି ଇମେଜ୍
ସାର୍ ସାର୍ ଆସୁନି Dear learners, due to some technical problem, ଟିକେ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ହେଇଛି ହେଲା ସାର୍ ଆସିବେ ବହୁତ ଶୀଘ୍ର ହି ୱିଲ୍ ଜଏନ୍ ଭେରି ସୁନ୍ ସୋ ଲାଷ୍ଟ କ୍ଲାସ୍ ସାର୍ ଯେଉଁଟା ଡିସ୍କସ୍ କରିଥିଲେ ତାକୁ ଆଉ ଟିକେ ବି ରିଭିଜନ୍ କରିଦେବେ ଇଫ୍ ଟାଇମ୍ ପ୍ରୋଭାଇଡ୍ ଦେନ୍ ସାର୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଡିସ୍କସ୍ ଓକେ ସାର୍ ଅଲରେଡ଼ି କମ୍ ना
सर कैमरा आउ
कंटिन्यू करिवा में प्लीज कंटिन्यू ओके
हां सर देन वी गो मैन गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट some major security threats in information system among all one is hacking is one of them hacking means gaining access to a computer system without the knowledge of the of its owner normally in hacking we are using SQL attacks session hijacking buffer overflow and port scans normally you are using this type of hacking for information security threats then next type of security threats is viruses and worms programs that make the computer system not to work properly in this is known as virus this means you are the user's intention is not very clear in case of virus attack viruses are normally of polygraphic virus tunneling virus droppers and cavity virus then we go for the trojaners trojaners means these programs are having two components one runs as a server and another one runs as a client this means data integrity attacks steal private information on the targeted system stole keystrokes and make it viewable for hackers sending private local as an email attacks this type of attack is known as trojaners this is a major security threats in information security then we go for the spoofing spoofing is one type of attack normally in case of spoofing computer users are normally sent to a link that stores that secure their information coming from the legitimate users example including IP snooping DNS snooping ARP spoofing these are the examples of spoofing then we go for the snipping snipping is one type of hacking tools or techniques in that case login id passwords can be gained by the hackers also in case of snipping tcp dump and snoop are better example of snipping tools then the last we'll go for the dos denial of service attack the main aim of this attack is to bring down the targeted networks and to make it deny the service for legitimate users in order to do the denial of service attack people do not need to be an expert they can attack with a simple pinging command also by the help of the network then the next topic is vulnerability normally vulnerability are the weaknesses that can be used to harm us in essence they are holes that can be exploited by threats in order to cause us harm vulnerability might be a specific operating systems or application that are running this is running a physical location where we can choose to place our office building data centers these are known as the normally vulnerability then you go for the type of vulnerability some weakness of the system or vulnerability are physical vulnerability natural vulnerability hardware or versus software vulnerability hardware or software vulnerability media vulnerability then the emanation vulnerability communication vulnerability and human vulnerability among these type of vulnerability normally done in case of the organization physical vulnerability are done by the through employees it means social interaction customer interaction discussing work in public location taking data in the office like paper mobile phones laptops emailing documents data mailing and faxing documents these are comes under vulnerability through employees security vulnerability through employees then we go for the through former employees suppose former employees working for the competitors former employees retaining company data former employees discussing company matters this is also one type of vulnerability then vulnerability through technology suppose you are using social networking file sharing rapid technology changes then legacy systems storing data in mobile devices these are also comes under vulnerability through technology then vulnerability through hardware suppose susceptibility to dust heat humidity hardware design flaws out of date hardwares, misconfiguration of hardwares. These are normally comes under vulnerability through hardwares. Then we go for the vulnerability through software. Insufficient testing, lack of audit trials, software bugs, design faults, unchecked user inputs. These are called as vulnerability through softwares. Then vulnerability through network. Suppose unprotected network communication, open physical connections, IP and ports, insecure network architectures. These are normally comes under vulnerability through networks. Then this is another type of vulnerability, vulnerability through IT management. Suppose insufficient IT capacity, missed security patches, insufficient incidents, problem management, configuration errors, missecure notice. These are comes under vulnerability through IT management. Then next type of vulnerability means human vulnerability. This is known as the partner and supplier vulnerability. Suppose distribution of telephone services, telecom services, disruption of utility services such as electricity and any other hardware failures, software failures, loss of mail, courier packages. These are comes under vulnerability and type of human vulnerability type. Based on the vulnerability, normally you are calculating the risk also. What is the meaning of risk? Risk is the potential that can give threats who will exploit vulnerability of an asset or group of asset and thereby cause them harm to the organization. This, for that purpose, normally in case of organization, they are performing risk management. Risk management, normally risk management consists based on a formula. This means risk is equal to threats into vulnerability. Risk is combination of threats and vulnerability combined to perform risk. In case of risk management, we are processing first identifying the risk, then controlling the risk or minimizing the risk or avoiding the risk. These are the main techniques normally used in case of risk management. For example, suppose risk business disruption, what are the risk normally happens in your organization? Business disruption, financial losses, loss of privacy, damage to reputation, loss of confidence, legal penalties, impaired growth and loss of files. These are comes under risk category. Risks normally comes on threats into vulnerability. What are the threats? Angry employees, dishonest employees, criminals, government, terrorists, the media personnel, competitors, hackers, natural risk. These are comes under natural threats. These are comes under threats category. When threats are multiplied with vulnerability, then risk comes. What are the vulnerability factors that comes? Software bugs, broken processes, inefficient controls, hardware flaws, business changes, legacy systems, human errors. These are normally comes under vulnerability factors. Risk is normally threats into vulnerability considered as a risk. Then we go for this is the portal of information security and vulnerability threats. Then you go for the virus, worms and other malwares. What is the meaning of malwares? Malware stands for malicious software, and it is designed to gain access or install into the computer without the consent of the users. This is known as malware. They perform unwanted tasks in the host computer for the benefit of the third party. Normally, malware's role is to give benefit to the third party. There is a full range of malwares which can seriously degrade the performance of the host machines and are simply written to distract or annoy the users, to the complex ones which captures the sensitive data from the host machine and send it to the remote servers. This is the role of a malware. In this chapter, normally we are going to study the type of malwares, type of viruses, and type of worms. These are the main focuses of the chapter 2. Then we go for the type of malwares. Normally, malwares are hardwares. Hardware is a type of malware. Then spyware is also a type of malware. Browser hacking software is a type of malware. Then virus and worms is also one type of malwares. Then we go for the popular malware, adwares. It is a special type of malware which is used to force advertising. normally in case of web browsing, malwares are given to for a particular purpose to redirecting the page to someone's advertising page, pop up in the additional page which promotes some product or events. These adwares are financially supported by the organization whose products are advertised. By this way, they can also fetch your IP addresses and also divert you to similar websites also. This is the role of adwares. Then we go for the spywares. Spywares, it is a special type which is installed in the targeted computer with or without the user permission. Normally, spywares are installed to the user computer without the permission of the users and is designed to steal sensitive information from the targeted machine. Its main aim is to extract the sensitive information from the target machine. Mostly it is gather the browsing habits of the users and send it to the remote server without the knowledge of the owner of the computer. This is the main role, is to gather the browsing habits of the user and send it to the remote server. Most of the times, they are downloaded to the host computers. While downloading freewares or free application programs from the internet, the spywares comes to the picture. Spywares may be the virus types. It can keep track of the cookies of the host computer. It can act as the key lockers to sniff the banking passwords and sensitive information from the user also. This is the role of a spyware. Then third category is browser hacking software. There are some malicious software which are downloaded along with the free softwares offered on the internet and installed in the host computer without the knowledge of the users. This is known as browser hacking software. These softwares modify the browser settings and redirect the links to the unintentional sites. This is the main role, is to modify the browser settings, normally modify the browser settings and redirect the link to the unintentional sites. They can fetch your details also. Then you go for the virus. Virus, as the name suggests, virus is vital information resources underseas. A virus is a malicious code written to damage or harm the host computer by deleting or appending the file, occupying memory space of the computer, by replicating the copy of the code. This is the role of virus. Slow down the performance of the computer, format the host machine. These are the main role of the virus. It can spread via email. Normally, viruses are spread by email attachment, pen drives, digital images, e-greetings, audio and video clips also. This is the way of spreading the virus. A virus may be present in a computer, but it cannot active itself without the human intervention. It means until and unless the executable file, it means the .exe file, is executed, a virus cannot be activated in the host machine. The virus's main role is to activate it by the help of an .exe files to be executed in your host computer. Then we go for the type of, then we go for the next type. This is known as worms. They are a class of virus which can replicate it by themselves. Worms normally is a class of virus which can replicate it by themselves. They are different from the virus by the fact that they does not require human intervention. Normally, viruses are needs human intervention, but worms does not need human intervention to travel over the network and spread from the infected machine to the whole network. This main role is to spread from the infected machine to the whole network. Worms can spread either through the network using the loopholes of the operating system or via emails. The replication and spreading of worms over the network consumes the network resources like space, bandwidth, and force to the network to choke. It is a program. Normally, worms is a program that views the infection point as another computer rather than as executable files or an already infected computers. The worms' normal role is to replicate it by themselves among the computer itself. Does not need any human intervention. Then this is a one type of, normally worms are of different types. In Win32 is a one type of worm, which is known as Win32 conflicker. This is a one type of worm which can commute by itself in the network without the help of intervention. This can checked without strong passwords, securing shared folders by internet, the main role of the Win32 for configure org. Then you go for the Trojaners. Trojan is one type of worm or is a virus, is a place of software designed to look like a useful file of software programs, but performs possible disruption or functions installed in the client computer. The viruses take its name like Trojaners. Trojaners viruses differ from other computer viruses in that they are not designed to spread themselves. Instead, Trojaners malware is either delivered as a payload of the another virus or piece of malware through manual end user actions by downloading or infected files or inserting infected drives into a computer. Once a computer is infected with Trojaners virus, the malware can be designed to steal end user information, performs destructive harm on the targeted computer. This is the main role of the Trojaners. And Trojaners virus will normally consist of a server and client component. The client component is the protection of the malware that infects the end users' computers. Once it is established or executed, the virus can be designed to establish a certain level of control over the infected computers. This is the main role of the Trojaners virus. It not only damages the host computers by manipulating the data, but also it creates a backdoor in the host computer so that it could be controlled by the remote computer also. This is the main role of the Trojaners. Then we go for the scareware. Scareware is a type of malware which can spread on internet. It has even changed the way how the criminal target the people for ransom. While surfing the internet, suddenly a pop-up alert appears on the screen which warns the presence of dangerous virus like spywares, etc. As a remedial measures, the message suggests the use downloads the pull-paid version of the software. As the user proceeds, as the user proceeds to download malicious codes known as scarewares to download it into the host computer. It holds the most computer hostage until the ransom is paid. The malicious code can neither be uninstalled nor can the computer be used till the ransom is paid. This is just type of spywares. Then we go for the viruses. After completion of the worms, then we go for the viruses. Computer viruses are classified into two categories. One is non-resident virus, and second one is resident virus. Non-resident virus means this kind of virus will execute along with its host to perform the needful actions of finding and infecting the other possible files and eventually transfer the control back to the main program. This is the role of a non-resident virus. Resident virus means in case of resident viruses, whenever the infected program is run by the user, the virus gets activated, loads its replication module into the memory, and then transfer the control back to the main program. In this case, the virus still remains active in the memory, waiting for an opportunity to find and infect the other files. This is the role of the resident viruses. Then you go for the type of viruses. Type of viruses normally consist of five types. One is file viruses, another one is boot sector virus, microvirus, electronics mail by email virus, then multivariant virus are of the category of viruses category. Then we go fast to it, go for the topic like file virus. File virus use the file system of a given operating system to propagate. File viruses include viruses that infect executable files. Executable files. Normally, file viruses are known as the script virus, written in one of a variety of script languages like Visual Basic Script, JavaScript, Windows, Bash, PHP, either infected other scripts by the help of file viruses also. Normally, script viruses are able to infect other file formats such as hypertext, Markov language. It is that file format which allows execution of the scripts. Then we go for the next, boot sector virus. This type of virus infects the boot sector or the master boot record, or displaces the active boot sector of a hard drive. This is the main role. Once the hard drive is booted up, boot sector viruses load themselves into the computer's memory. Many boot sector viruses, once executed, prevents the OS from the booting. This is the main role of the boot sector virus. The boot sector viruses will widespread in the from the year of 1990 onwards. Almost disappeared since the introduction of 32-bit processors and nearly disappearance of the floppy disks as a storage medium for executions. Normally, boot sector viruses are not in the impact while 32-bit processors comes. Then you go for the microvirus. Macrovirus are the word spreading virus, accounting, editing, project applications. It propagates by exploiting micro languages properties in order to transfer itself from the infected files containing the macro scripts to another files. The most widespread microviruses are Microsoft Office applications like Word, Excel, PowerPoint accesses, because they are written in the code of application software. Microviruses are the platforms independent and that can be spread between Mac, Windows, Linux, and any other systems running the targeted application. This is the main role of microviruses. Then we go for email virus or electronic mail virus. Email virus can be used to transmit any of the above type of virus by copying and emailing itself to the every address in the victim's email address book, usually within an email attachment. Each time a recipient opens the infected attachment, the virus harvests that victim's email address book and repeats its propagation process. Email viruses refers to the delivery mechanism rather than the infection target or behavior. This is the role of email viruses or electronic mail virus. Then multivariant virus. The same core virus but implemented with slight variations. This is known as multivirus virus. Multivariation viruses are of two types. One is polymorphic and another one is metamorphic virus. In case of polymorphic virus, is the virus which changes their characteristics after each infection. There are various techniques which are employed to achieve polymorphism by self modification of code, and hence infected files are infected with different variants. And in other cases, the virus encrypted with itself with a different key for different files. Metamorphic virus is the type of virus that is rewritten such that each iteration, so that each succeeding virus codes or versions codes is different from the preceding ones. Then we go for what are the distributing virus over internet? How creating and distributing virus over internet? Normally, we are using four type of different distributed environment to flow the viruses. Then one, this is a type is microvirus. This type of virus usually comes as the part of document spreadsheet upon emails. Then boot sector virus. This type of virus overrides the boot sectors on hardware drive or floppy drive. File infector virus. This type of virus attaches itself to executes in the computer. For example, any .com files or .exe files. Then stealth virus. This type of virus pull antivirus softwares by catching its request to the operating system. Then we go for the self-modifying virus. This type of virus, was designed to avoid detection by the antivirus softwares by changing itself internally. These are the type of viruses creating the distributing over internet. Then we go for the type of worms. Normally worms are of seven types. These are the email worms, instant messaging worms, instant relay chat worms, web or internet worms, or P2P mechanism copies type of shared folder worms, then harpool worms and flash worms. These are the type. Normally worms propagated by file attachment or email attachments via link to the web portals, FTP sources, links sent to the URL also, peer-to-peer file sharing networks. Normally these are the environments where worms can split by itself. Then we discuss the type of worms, email worms. They spread via infected email attachments embedded in an email attachment which must be opened by the intended victims to enable the worms to install itself on the victim's host. This is the main role of email worms. Instant messaging worms, it means they spread via infected attachments to reader access to URLs, uniform resource locators in IM message that point to malicious websites from which the worm is also downloaded. This is a type of instant messaging worms. Then instant relay chat worms and IRC worms is comparable to instant messaging worms, but exploit IRC rather than IM channels also. Instant messaging channels also. Web or internet worms, they can spread via user accesses, web pages like FTP sites and other internet resources in case of peer-to-peer file sharing worms, and also example of web internet worms. Then we go for the type of wormhole worm. It is a worm conceived by a researcher at University of California. This type of worm is a property to spread across the internet to infect all vulnerable servers within 15 minutes of activation. This is the main role of wormhole worms. Then flash worms. It is a theoretical worm that spreads within seconds of activation to all of the vulnerable holes on the internet. These are the main role of the worms. This is the end of chapter 2. Normally in chapter 2 we are discussing malwares and its type, viruses and its type, and worm and its type. Then we go for the security measures. In chapter 3 we are going to check the security countermeasures. What are the different security countermeasures? What are inside and outsider attacks? What is IDS, intrusion detection systems? What are the different type of IDS and what is an antivirus? These are the topics to be discussed in the chapter 3, security countermeasures. Then we go for type of attacks. In type of attacks, we divide type of attacks in insider attacks. An insider attack is a malicious attack pretend on a network or computer system by a person with authorized system access, such as employees, former employees, contractors, business associates who have inside the information concerning the organization security practices, data and computer system. These are known as the insider attacks. Insider that performs attacks have advantages over external attacks because they have authorized system access and also familiar with the network architecture. These type of attacks are normally done by the business associates, former employers, contractors also. Then type of insider attacks. First we go for the comprised attackers. Insiders with access credential or computing devices that have been comprised by the outsiders threat actors. These insiders may challenge the addresses since the real attack is coming from the outside. Then unintentional attackers, the insiders whose exposed data accidentally, such as an employee who access company data through public Wi-Fi without the knowledge and it is unsecured. By that case, also attackers takes the data and create some attack. Then the third category is emotional attackers. Insiders who steal data or destroy company networks unintentionally, such as former employees who injected malwares or logic bombs in corporate computers in his last day of his work. This is known as emotional attackers. Then tech savvy attackers. It means insider who react or to challenge. They use their knowledge or weaknesses, vulnerability to breach clearance and access sensitive information. This is known as tech savvy attackers. Tech savvy attackers can pose some of the most dangerous insider threats. They are likely to be sell confidential information, external parties, or blank market vendors. This is the main role of the tech savvy attackers. For preventing, how to prevent the insider attackers? For preventing, we are using several steps. In giving permissions to allotments, file sharing and internet networks, recognize suspicious behavior, assigning owners. These are the main steps normally used in an organization to prevent insider attackers. Then go for the outsider attackers. Outsider threats occurs when an individual or a group seeks to gain protected information by infiltrating and taking over profiles of a trusted users from outside of the organizations. It means attacks created by some ex-employees or authorized nodes on the networks. However, the adverse may have access to the physical medium, particularly if you are dealing with wireless networks. The outsider attackers can also enter into it. Therefore, attacks such as replay messages falls into classifications. These are the main role. However, coping with this attack is fairly easy by using traditional security techniques such as encryption, digital signatures. Then another category is malicious attackers whose various methods, tools, techniques enter to disturb and steal information from the system. This is the main role of outsider attackers. The outsider attackers, they are using different type of outsider attackers. We are checking email hacking is also one example of outsider attackers. Social engineering, intrusion attacks, denial of service attack. These are concerned outsider attackers. Email hacking. The most common mail transfer protocol like SMTP, POP3 do not typically include provisions for reliable authentication as part of the core protocol, allowing email messages to easily forged. Although extension of these basic protocols do exist, the decision whether to use the need to be established as part of the mail server. This is the main role of the email hacking. Then social engineering. In case of social engineering, it can be used both by the outsider and the people within the organization also. Social engineering is a hacker term for tricking people into revealing their passwords or some form of security information. A common example of social engineering would be where hackers send emails to an employee claiming to an administrator who needs the employee's password, do some administrative work. This is the main role of social engineering type of attack. Then the third category is intrusion attack. This often happens when attackers use known vulnerability in the networks. In updated system, administrators may not have to take the time to install all the necessary patches in a large number of hosts. This type of attack is known as intrusion attacks. Then the fourth category of outsider attack is denial of service attack, is a popular attack, DOS attack. DOS attack are designed to prevent legitimate use of the services. Attackers achieve by folding a network with the more traffic than it can be handled. For example, disturbing connection between two computers, preventing communication between services, preventing a particular individuals from accessing a service, disruption services to a specific system or client. This is the main role of denial of service attack. Then you go for what, how to prevent outsider attackers. These are the main things, how to normally in a big organization, they are using firewalls in the system to prevent outsider attackers, backup recovery methods. These are the helpful methods to protect outsider attacks. These are the points to be note to check the outsider attackers. Keep the virus database of your antivirus program updated. Scan your system once in a week to look out the new bugs to check. Be alert of emails and that ask personal information. Scan USB devices that you use for transferring data. Keep your web browser updated from time to time. These are the main points to check for preventing outsider attackers. Then you go for the topic, intruder detection, IDS. An intruder detection is a device or software application that monitors network or system activities for malicious activities or policy violations and procedures, policy violation and procedures report to a management. In some cases, IDS may also respond to anomalous and malicious traffic by taking actions such as blocking the user resources, IP addresses from accessing the network. In case of IDS and intrusion prevention system, IPS is a type of IDS that can prevent unwanted traffic. The IPS usually locks such events and the related information. Intrusion detection system usually performs the following activities. These are the monitoring and analysis of users and system activities. This is the main role of IDS. Auditing of system configurations and vulnerability. Accessing the integrity of critical system and data files. This is the role of IDS. Statistical analysis of activity patterns based on matching to known attacks. This is also the role of IDS. Abnormal activity analysis, operating system audit. These are the activities carried on IDS, intrusion detection system. Then we go for the component of IDS. Normally IDS, the three main components of IDS are network intrusion detection system, NIDS. This is normally placed between the internet and the host computer. Network intrusion detection system, NIDS, it performs an analysis for passing traffic on the entire subnet. Works in a works in between the host computer and carrier. And then in between network switch is also in one device which is connected to NIDS also. Once the attack is identified or abnormal behavior is sensed, the alert can be sent to the administrators. For example, the example of the NIDS would be installing it in the subnet where we use firewalls are located in order to see if someone is typing or breaking into the firewalls. NIDS is come to the picture or informate. Then you go for HIDS, means host intrusion detection system. It takes a snapshot of your existing system files and matches it to the previous snapshot. It is a critical system file where modified or deleted. The alert is sent to the administrator to investigate. For example, the HIDS can be seen on the mission critical machines that are not expected to change their configuration. The main role of NIDS is also helpful in case of firewalls using in the organization. This is known as host-based IDS, host intrusion detection system. Then third category is NNIDS. NNIDS means network node intrusion detection system. It performs the analysis of the traffic that is passed from the network to a specific host. The difference between NIDS and NNIDS is that the traffic is monitored on the single host only and not on the entire subnet. For example, of the NIDS, it should be installed in the VPN devices. For example, the traffic once it was decrypted, this way you can see someone is typing or breaking into the VPN devices also. Then we go for the topic function of IDS. Normally IDS are performing observing and monitoring function. In observing and monitoring mode, an IDS observe the system and the network for any suspicious events. The criteria for observation depends on the type of IDS. It means logging of events. Once encountering a suspicious activity, the IDS records the information related to the observed activity. This is the main role. This is either performed locally by the concerned system or by a centralized logging server. This logging or events is normally done by the standalone machine also. Then alerting system administrator, once the event has been logged into a database, the IDS can be set up to be send alert to the system administrator, and IDS can send alert through web pages, email messages, etc. Then you go for IDS intrusion detection methods. Normally, intrusion detection methods, broadly there are two types of detection methods, namely signature based and anomaly based detection. These are the two types of intrusion detection methods we are using. Signature based IDS refer to the detection of attacks by logging for specific patterns such as byte sequence in network traffic or known malicious instruction sequences used by the malwares. This is the terminology originated from antivirus softwares, which refers to these detected patterns as signatures. Although signature based IDS can easily detect from the known attacks, it is possible to detect new attacks for which no pattern is also available. This is based on signature based intrusion detection. Then anomaly based intrusion detection means anomaly based IDS were primarily introduced to detect unknown attacks. In part due to the rapid development of malwares, the basic approach is to use machine learning to create model of the trusted activities and then compare new behavior against this model. This is known as anomaly based intrusion detection. In this approach enables the detection of previously known attacks. It suffers from the false positives. Previously unknown legitimate activities may also be classified as a anomaly based intrusion detection system. Then we go for the application of intrusion detection system. Intrusion detection system can be implemented by an organization for the following reasons. It means an IDS tends to act as an external layer for protection along with the other security mechanism in an organization. Its aim in the process of detecting intrusions and other malicious events when other security measures in the organization falls. It can detect an attacks in its preliminary stage when the attackers initiate a port scan to determine vulnerability of ports. It can log event and present reports that can be used by the system administrator. It provides an easy techniques for analyzing the security measures of an organization. IDS is also helpful for this reason. then we go for intrusion prevention system. Then the intrusion prevention system.
एबे सर आसुथला आपण जो करूतले हां जे ट्राई करंतु तो प्रेजेंट हो टिकट टिकट ट्राई करंतु
असला की सर से कोन स्टॉप मी यू आर प्रेजेंट
हां प्रेजेंट हां प्रेजेंट हो छी हां
हां किंतु फोटो आसुनी सर
आज्ञा
डेट एबे असला की सर
हां प्रेजेंट तो देखौ जी
हां सर intrusion prevention system IPS is also known as intrusion detection and prevention system IDPS. This is normally used in network security applications that monitor networks or systems activity for malicious activity.
apan presentation ta asuni sir presentation apan ko asuni
sir mu eta sarla par share kar dibe apan
hau sir par ha pore share kar dibe apan class continue kar okay continue
Intrusion prevention system consider as extension of intrusion detection systems. In this case, both monitor network traffic and as well as system activities for malicious behaviors. The main difference are, unlike intrusion detection systems, intrusion prevention systems are placed in line and able to actively prevent the block of intrusion detection. This is the main goal of and offending IP addresses, resetting connections, blocking traffic. This is the main goal of intrusion prevention system. Then we go for the antivirus softwares. Antivirus sometimes known as anti-malware softwares is a computer software used to prevent or detect, remove malicious softwares. Antivirus softwares are originally developed to detect, remove computer viruses. This is the main role of the antivirus software. Then the identification methods of viruses. How viruses can be identified? What are the possible methods to identify the virus? Signature-based detection. It is generally used. Is the most common method to identify viruses, viruses and other malwares. The antivirus engine. The antivirus engine compares the contents of a file. Or its database known as malware signatures. Then this is the next category of heuristic based detection. It is generally used to use together with signature based detection. It detects malware based on characteristics typically used in the known malware codes. Then third category is behavioral based detection. In case of behavioral based detection, it is a similar type of heuristic based detection. And used also in the IDS intrusion detection system. The main difference is that instead of characteristics hard coded in the malware code itself, it is based on the behavioral fingerprint of the malwares run at a time. Clearly, this technique is able to detect malwares only after when they are starting doing their malicious actions. This is the main role of behavioral based action detection. Then sandbox detection. It is a particular behavioral based detection techniques that instead of detecting the behavioral fingerprint at runtime, it executes the program in a virtual environment, logging with actions that the program performs. Depending on the actions log, the antivirus engine can determine the program is malicious or not. The program is executed in the real environment and this technique is also helpful to gather the effectiveness of the operating system also. How it rarely used to end users antivirus solutions, normally sandbox detection. Then data mining techniques is one of the latest approach applied to malware detection. Data mining is mining and machine learning algorithm are used to classify the behavior of the file. It means either it is malicious or not. Gives a series of file features that are extracted from the file itself. This is a role of data mining based detection. Normally, in case of signature based detection, traditional antivirus softwares release behavior of a signature to the identified malwares. Substance live when malwares arrives in the hand of antivirus firms, it analyzed by malware researchers or by dynamic analysis system they are using. Then once it is determined to be a malware, a proper signature of the file is extracted and added to the signature database of the antivirus software. This is the role of signature based detection. When a particular file has to be scanned, the antivirus engine compares the content of the file with all malware signatures in the signature database. If the file matches one signature, then the engine knows which malware it is and which procedure has to be performed in order to clean the infection. This is the role of signature based detection method. Then the next approach is heuristic approach. In case of heuristic approach, some more sophisticated antivirus software use heuristic analysis to identify new malwares or variants of known malwares. Many viruses start as a single infection, and though either mutation or refinements by other attackers can grow into dozens and slightly different strains called variants. Generic detection refers to the detection and removal of multiple threats using a single virus definition. Normally, virus researchers find common areas that all viruses in a family share uniquely and can be thus created single generic signature that can be created single generic signature. Single generic signature. These signatures often contain non-contiguous codes using wildcard characters. These must be checked by the method of heuristic approach. These wildcards allows the scanner to detect viruses even they are padded with extra and meaningless codes. The detection method is normally helpful in case of heuristic approach. This is known as heuristic detection. Then rootkit detection. This is a real-time protection on access scanning background. There is antivirus softwares can attempt to scan for rootkits. A rootkit is a type of malware designed to gain administrative level control over a computer system without being detected. Rootkit can change how the operating system functions, and in some cases can tamper with antivirus programs and render its ineffectiveness. Rootkit are also difficult to remove, in some cases requiring complete reinstallation of the operating system also to remove rootkit detection. These are then we come for real-time protection. This is the last plan of preventing antivirus. Real-time protection means on access scanning, background guards, recent sealed auto protect, and other synonyms refers to the automatic protection provided by the most antivirus spyware and other antivirus anti malware programs. These monitor computer systems for suspicious activities such as computer viruses, spywares, hardwares, and other malicious objects in real time. In other words, while data loaded into the computer's active memory by the help of inserting some CD or opening an email or browsing the web, the real-time protection comes into the pictures. When a file already in the computer is opened or executed, in that case, real-time protection is activated, being automatically activated. This is the role of real-time protection activity. In antivirus software, we are using five methods: identification methods of viruses, signature-based detections, heuristic approaches, rootkit detection, and real-time protection. This is the end of the third chapter. Sir. Sir, any doubt?
Hello. Yes, sir.
Sir. Any doubt?
Okay, sir. We'll start some question answer session, I think so.
Sure.
And with some example, so learners are waiting.
Sure.
So there are some questions regarding this. First, sir, worms. Worms ta kono atikke seven type of jo worms hoche. Taku tikke sir describe kor diyon. Describe the seven type of. Sir, with example. Tikke example soi to taki student mane tikke bhala bhabe bujhi paribe. Worms ta.
Worms' main aim is to replicated by themselves. It means once it is affected by the computer system, it is automatically spread. Normally, in case of viruses are caused by the help of some .exe or .com files. Any attachments or any emails coming and in any emails, if any .exe files are come to the picture. When the users double click it is automatically spread over the computers. This is the role of virus. But worms are automatically created by the help of different applications. It means worms can spread either through the networks using the loopholes of the operating system or via email. Normally worms can be spread and it can be replicated by the help of itself. When network resources like space, bandwidths, it can be forced to be replicated by itself.
No. Yes, sir, seven type of worms.
Sir. Seven type of worms. Seven type of worms. Normally, email worms is one of its type. It means they can spread by the infected email attachments. Suppose some attachment is there. If we click on the, suppose a job offer is in the heading of the mail, a job offer is coming. Once you click on the mail, then you redirect it to the another .exe file where worms can be automatically created. This is a one way of email worms. It means intended user gives you a mail like your interest. When you click on the mail, it will be automatically infected. It means copy the discriminants by itself. It is one type of email worms. Then instant messaging worms. It means they spread via infected attachments to internet messages or reader access to the URL. Suppose you are typing a URL. If any letter is missing, means it will be redirected to a worm sites also. This is the role of second instant messaging worms. Then instant relay chat worms. It is compared to the instant messaging worm, but it can be it will be exploited in the help of internet also. Then web or internet worms. It means they spread via user access or to the web pages. It means file transfer sites, peer-to-peer communications, internet resources by using public networks, public Wi-Fi. You can also be affected by worms automatically. It means copying itself into a spread of shared folders. They can use P2P mechanism, means peer-to-peer mechanism, to announce its existence in hopes that other P2P users will download it and execute it. Its role is like that. Then warhol worms. It is a worm convinced by the researchers. It is normally used in case of a vulnerable servers. Within 15 minutes of activations, it can be infected the entire system which is connected to the server. Then last category of worm is flash worm. It means it is a theoretical worm that spreads within a second to activation of vulnerable host in the internet. It means email bombs comes under a flash worm also. Suppose some attachment is on your email. If you click on the attachment, then it will be automatically corrupt your operating system and catch your information to the intended user also.
Okay, sir.
The best example of worm is the rat. Nowadays, Pakistan worm rat. RAT is a worm which is automatically flashed in the network also to catch the entire server details to the intended users.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Next is what is the difference between IM, capital IM worms, and IRC worms? That is, IM means IM, that is instant messaging.
IM means instant messaging. IRC means instant
and
relay
IMC.
IRC, instant relay chat.
Instant relay chat. Instant messaging and instant relay messaging.
Relay chat means it is a guided worm. Suppose someone is guiding you to check on the box or click on the box to by that category of worms. This is a relay chat worm. And then third party is guiding you to create some viruses. Sir.
Okay, sir. Next question, what is the difference between capital HIDS and NNIDS? With example.
IDS stands for intrusion detection system. It means it comes under sir, what is again the question? IDS versus HIDS.
HIDS versus double N. IDS.
HIDS means
HIDS and
NNIDS. Okay. In case of NNIDS, it performs an analysis or passing traffic on the entire subnet. It means suppose someone is want to hacking the Yahoo site or Google site, by that case NNS come to the picture. Normally NNS covers the helps to firewalls to detect from any interruption coming under the firewalls. It means any interruption from the any subnet or any users comes to the network, it can be checked there. It does not affect to the router, it does not affect to the server also in case of NNDS. NNDS means NNDS installed on the subnet where firewall is installed. I mean, this is the main protection of NNDS. But in case of HIDS, host intrusion detection, it takes a snapshot of your existing system files and matches with the prevention of the snapshot. Any event comes to the picture, it will be automatically guided to the database which is present previously in the HIDS, and it is matched. If the critical system files were modified or detected, the alert is sent to the administrator to investigate. It means any modification in the network, HIDS comes to the picture. Or any activity, any modification or revisioning or any attachment is come to the network, then HIDS comes to the picture. HIDS can see the mission critical mechanism that are expected to change in the configuration of the entire system. This is the role of HIDS. Sir.
Thank you, sir. Next question is difference between polymorphic, metamorphic, and self-modifying virus with example.
In case of polymorphic, metamorphic means normally viruses are main aim is to give some malicious behavior inside the computers. Virus is normally means vital information resources underseas. In case of metamorphic and polymorphic, in case of polymorphic virus is automatically created by itself. In case of polymorphic virus, the virus is based on some internal factors. To give you the one real-time examples. Type of virus. In case of polymorphic, the virus which changes their characteristics after the each infection. It means it will automatically created its position, it created its sense of behavior. It may this is known as polymorphic. By itself, it can be changed. Polymorphism by the self modification. It means it is automatically changed by itself. Metamorphic means the virus that rewritten. Once the virus is affected, it will be rewritten by each iteration. Suppose one iteration is complete, once you face the virus by the help of some antivirus, it will be again come to the pictures by the help of some new virus. In that case, the metamorphic viruses are comes to the picture with their different versions of the code in different form of the viruses is known as the metamorphic virus. Polymorphic viruses are encrypted by itself. It is also differ from the file virus.
Sir. Okay, thank you, sir. Learners out to give me chahun to kichi practical mane kichi kori ki dekhe hebo ki e jo
हाँ सर ईमेल अटैचमेंट से मैंने चेक करी परिवे एक्चुअली कौन कि हैकर्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू रु गोटे ईमेल अटैचमेंट से मैंने दे परिवे पोजीशन नहीं परिवे आईपी एड्रेस ट्रेसिंग करी परिवे आईपी एड्रेस ऑफ द सर्वर ट्रेस कर परिवे नहीं किंतु आईपी एड्रेस ऑफ द क्लाइंट भी ट्रेस कर परिवे बाय द हेल्प ऑफ सम ईमेल बॉक्स मैंने कोई गोटे अटैचमेंट दे कि तार अटैचमेंट को यदि किसी क्लिक कर चेक करियो प्लाटफर्म दरकार किंतु प्रोसीजर होला आपण एई सब प्रोसीजर रे गेन करि परबे एक्सेस सपोज गोटे कंप्यूटर तो आपण कनेक्ट कला जेंते हम आईपी टाकू ट्रेस करिया पे आईपी कॉन्फिग मारि के देखु छे कोन आईपी अछि कि तार रूट टाकू ट्रेस करिया पे इंटरनेट पे हम देखु छे पिंग करि के देखु छे एस्टैब्लिश करु छे से पिंग एस्टैब्लिशमेंट टाइम रे जने हैकर जानि परबे जे केते नोड्स अछि केते नोड काउंट मेथड रे से माने लिंक टा एस्टैब्लिश करु छे ए सब जिंस जने हैकर्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू रिक्वायर्ड नॉर्मली जानला परे जानि परियो जे कोडी फायरवॉल अछि कोडी सबनेट अछि तेनु देन सर्वर को टच कर परियो नले सर्वर टच कर परियो एटा पटे खाली हमें मेथड नॉर्मली पढु छे किंतु तंगो काम करिया पय हले तंगो दरकार लिनक्स प्लेटफार्म रे तंगो चेक करिया रछ जति कि नेटवर्क में सपोर्ट दरकार सर्वर रे पहुंचे जाथु
ओके सर
तना जे प्रैक्टिकल काम कोटि पोजीशन रे को पोजीशन रे केमति कमांड देबे कोन करियो कहले मु बते परि
ओके सर इफ टाइम प्रोवाइड अपन नेक्स्ट टाइम रे टिके किछि प्रैक्टिकली गुटे जिंस कर दिए वर्म्स रिलेटेड किंबा एटैक्स रिलेटेड सिक्योरिटी रिलेटेड हमर कर के हां रे टिके पिलां गुटे के डेमो देखले दे विल अंडरस्टैंड वेरी ओके ओके सर थैंक यू सर थैंक यू फॉर ए ब्रिलियंट सेशन सो आई थिंक देयर आर ऑल क्वेश्चंस दैट हैज ऑलरेडी कवर्ड अपन के
से वीडियो टा शेयर कर दू छी अपन को मेल रे नेक्स्ट क्लास से जेते रिसेंट प्रिवेंशन टेक्निक्स अछि माने ओडिसा पुलिस
प्रेजेंटेशन भी शेयर कर देबे जोटा को मु स्टूडेंट को सहित शेयर कर देबे ओके सो सर हैज कवर ऑलरेडी ऑल द क्वेश्चंस सो नाउ विल वाइंड अप आवर सेशन हियर थैंक यू सर थैंक यू सुधीर सर थैंक यू भावेश सर एंड थैंक यू ऑल डियर लर्नर्स We will for you and we will take care all of your problems. Thank you.
Sir.
Mr. Himadri.
Sir.
No, Mr. Senapati, actually more of a request. Sir.
Oh, sir, cool.
From your presentation, from your classes, I sir. Appreciate you have got a very in-depth knowledge. Kintu, मैंने बीइंग ए डिस्टेंस एंड जस्ट लिसनिंग टू बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द टर्म्स आर टोटली न्यू फॉर अस तो आमको विजुअली से हेल्पफुल हम जदि आप साइमल्टेनियसली पीपीटी आमको देखेबे अदर तो ना प्रैक्टिकल हमें डार्क रहला पर जाना पड़ जाए मोस्ट ऑफ टर्म्स टोटल न्यू आम पे बहुत डिफिकल्ट हो फॉलो करा पे तो काइंडली इट्स माय रिक्वेस्ट नेक्स्ट फाइनली देखंतु
हां सर बिफोर एंड रे पीपीटी दे दो पीपीटी करथिली कि सिस्टम प्रॉब्लम पे जाई परनी
हां
एंड हिमाद्रो एक्चुअली आमर ग्रुप अछि आपण जदि हमहु इवन गोटे मेल रे पठैले लेकिन इंटरनली हमें शेयर कर दी करी
ओके ओके प्रभात प्रभात आई विल सेंड सम मटेरियल्स इन व्हाइट हैक व्हाइट हैकिंग आल्सो ओके 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 एनी अदर
नहीं दैट्स ऑल थैंक यू
ओके ओके थैंक यू ऑल ऑफ यू थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स ओके